I will be tall enough to reach the branches that I need to reach to climb the trees you get to climb when you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will be smart enough to answer all the questions that you need to know the answers to before you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will eat sweets every day on the way to work, and I will go to bed late every night.
And I will wake up when the sun comes up, and I will watch cartoons until my eyes go square, and I won't care cause I'll be all grown up when I grow up.
Started reeking. Quiet, maggot, when I'm speaking. Reeking with the most disturbing scent. Only the finest nostrils smell it, but I know it too well. It is the odor of rebellion. It's the bouquet of dissent. And you may bet your britches this headmistress finds this foul odoriferousness wholly olfactorily insulting. And so, to stop the stench's bread, I find a session of PZ. Thoughts the merely rank from the revolting. Come along, squits. I'll take it from here, Jenny. The smell of rebellion comes out in the sweat, and fizz ed will get you sweating, and it won't be long before I smell the pong of aiding and abetting. Before a weed becomes too big and greedy, you really need to nip it in the bud. Before the worm starts to turn, you must scrape off the dirt and rip it from the bud. A whiff of insurgence, the stench of intent, the reek of prepubescent protest, a pong of defiance, the odor of coup, the waft of anarchy in progress. Once we've exercised these demons, they shall be too pooped for scheming.
some double time discipline should stop the rot from setting in.
Discipline, discipline for children who aren't listening, for fiddlers who are fidgeting and whispering in history. They're chattering and chittering, they're nattering and twittering. He's tempered with a smattering of discipline. We must begin insisting on rigidity and discipline, persistently resisting this anarchistic mischief. In these minutes you are frittering on pandering and pitying. While little ones like this, you just indiscipline. The tempering and whimpering, the dribbling and the spittling, the misanimated issue, it's an issue we can fix. There is no mystery to mastering the art of classroom mistressing. It's discipline, discipline, discipline!
The smell of rebellion, the stench of revolt, the reek of prepubescent plotting, a whiff of resistance, the power of dissent. The stink of moral fiber rotting! Imagine a world with no children. Close your eyes and just dream. Imagine, go on, try it. The peace and the quiet, a burbling stream. Now imagine a woods with a cottage, and inside that cottage we find a parrot called Zeke, a carnival freak who can fold paper hats with his mind. And he says, don't let them steal your horses, don't let them take them away. If you find your way through, they'll be waiting for you, singing, nay.
She's mad.
Aha! And there, just like I said, the stinky maggot rears his head. Have you ever seen anything more repellent? Have you ever smelt anything worse than that? The scent of revolt, the reek of insubordination, a whiff of resistance, the power of dissent. And I will not stop till you are squashed, till this rebellion is quashed, till glorious sweaty discipline has washed this sickening stench away!
Have you ever wondered, well I have, about how when I say red? For example, there's no way of knowing if red means the same thing in your head as red means in my head when someone says red. And how if we are travelling at almost the speed of light and we're holding a light, that light would still travel away from us at the full speed of light, which seems right in a way. But I'm trying to say, I'm not sure, but I wonder if inside my head I'm just a bit different from some of my friends. These answers that come into my mind and bidden, these stories delivered to me fully written. And when everyone shouts like they seem to like shouting, the noise in my head is incredibly loud. And I just wish they'd stop, my dad and my mum, and the telly and stories would stop for just once. And I'm sorry, I'm not quite explaining it right. This noise becomes anger, and the anger is light. And it's burning inside me, would usually fade, but it isn't today. And the heat and the shouting, and my heart is pounding, and my eyes are burning, and suddenly everything, everything is
quiet. Like silence, but not really silent. Just that still sort of quiet. Like the sound of a page being turned in a book. Or a pause in a walk in the woods.
it. Like silence, but not really silent. Just that nice kind of quiet. Like the sound when you lie upside down in your bed. Just the sound of your heart in your head. And though the people around me, their mouths are still moving, the words they are forming cannot reach me anymore. And it is quiet, and I am warm. Like I've said,
you revolting little blunder.
Into the eye of the storm.
This is the end of the rebellion.
Left the gates of Hades.
I'm going to tear you apart.
Did that?
This roof keeps me dry when the rain falls. This door helps to keep the cold at bay. On this floor I can stand on my own 2 feet. On this chair I can write my lessons. On this pillow I can dream my nights away. And this table, as you can see, well, it's perfect for tea. It isn't much, but it is enough for me. It isn't much, but it is enough.
Miss Honey, she's got your father's house. She's got everything that's yours.
On these walls I hang wonderful pictures. Through this window I can watch the seasons change. By this lamp I can read. And I am set free. And when it's cold outside, I feel no fear. Even in the winter storms, I am warmed by a small but stubborn fire. And there is nowhere I would rather be. It isn't much, but it is enough for me. For this is my house. This is my house. It isn't much, but it is enough for me. This is my house. This is my house. It isn't much, but it is enough. And when it's cold and bleak, I feel no. Even when outside it's freezing, I don't pay much heed. I know that everything I need is in here. It isn't much, but it is enough for me. Much, but it is enough.
to be a little bit naughty. Never again will the choking door slam. Never again will I be bullied. And never again will I doubt it when my mummy says I'm a miracle.
Yes!
Never again will we live behind bars.
Never again are the we know we are. Revolting children living in revolting times. We sing revolting songs using revolting rhymes. We'll be revolting children till our revolting's done. And we'll have the Trunchbull bolting. We're revolting. We are revolting children living in revolting times. We sing revolting songs using revolting rhymes. We'll be revolting children till our revolting's done. And we'll have the Trunchbull bolting. We're revolting.
We will become a screaming horde. Take out your hockey stick and use it as a sword. Never again will we be ignored.
We'll find out where the chalk is stored.
And draw rude pictures on the board.
It's not insulting.
We're revolting.
Taking a step.